What you're about to witness is one amazing speaker system born out of the fires of Mordor, commonly known as the Genelec factory in
Iisalmi,
Finland.
Are you hypocrite and liar?
If you want a better way to do things, you'll have to create something new.
We could spend hours talking about the engineering behind this system. So instead, I will just point you to a great presentation that Genelec has on YouTube with the chief engineer
Aki Mäkivirta.
Thank you. Linked in the description, and just cover the basics here. The design objective of the 8381A was to create a placement-friendly and super-accurate freestanding main monitor that, in combination with the adaptive point source, allows for very flexible listening with mind-blowing dynamic range capability, access to details, and the optimal geometry in the position it is placed. Of course, there were no drivers in existence that could meet the demands for such design, so Genelec naturally developed both the two-way coaxial tweeter and the mid-range domes from scratch in-house. The design is clearly a result of function. Currently, the 8381A are available in black and white. These ladies might be a smidge too big for this room.
They're enormous. Nice. Be kind to me.
Yeah. Okay.
The system comes with two sizes of tilt plates that can be pushed in between the two cabinets, tilting the top down in case the listening position height requires it. Will that work for hi-fi? Let's start the listening journey and find out. To bring a nuanced justice to the participating speakers, we have formed a listening team of six profiles, including myself, ranging from audio professionals to hi-fi enthusiasts, some of which you have met here in other reviews, providing blind listening or second opinions. Not everybody on the team could make it in the time frame we had the speakers for review. All the sessions are conducted individually with the participants' own music, and no findings are shared between the members. Neither do I share any impressions, but the intentions of the construction in order for the listening team to investigate the claims made by the manufacturer. Several listening positions was established in the room so the listener could move around and hear if the design objectives is working. Before the start of each listening session, I do a safety briefing. Silverback team, you're among the finest listeners in the world. But make no mistake, gentlemen, you're now in harm's way. This is currently the single most dangerous object in the world. It's in control of unbelievable forces. The moment you lose respect for this, it can and it will destroy the only body part you care for as audiophiles. You got that, maggots?
Oh, yes, sir!
Good. So let's do some elite listening, shall we, gentlemen?
It's extremely easy to play much, much louder than you think on this system. In fact, you should use the volume knob with the same caution as you would use the words,
"Please castrate me."
As it is so clean, distortion-free, and totally effortless output-wise that the ears really don't receive any warning before it might be too late.
Let there be bass.
With really bass-heavy music, it can result in an almost primal lust to play even louder, like driving a Mercedes SLS AMG. Where the sound alone triggers your deepest primal instincts, urging you to push that accelerator hard, and again, and again.
Hell yeah!
For playback, we use different streamers, like the totally hyped Eversolo DMP-A6 Master Edition, that will be given a full honest review at a later date, and the Blue Sound Note X. DAC duties is handled by a new Prime Evolution 2 DAC that is connected to the C5000 preamp that feeds the Genelec power amps. All interconnect cables were in acoustic excellence and reference series cables that uses air as an insulator. The first thing all team members comment on is the way sound is almost carved out of the air.
This is Tim's typical music.
It's a pop princess, princess comes to town. I experience this at extremely stable stereo picture in the middle of the speakers, almost spookily mono-ish. Not because they're mono, but it's enormous, well-established and stable stereo picture. There's so much headroom in the bass, it invites you to play louder. Impressively stable delivery, very well controlled, enormous extension down in the bass, nice full-bodied sound. So it's a very disciplined, competent, solid speakers. Time will tell if they feel exciting enough. Mm-hmm. If they feel involving enough. Mm-hmm. But right now, they're very, very impressive what they delivered. I get their slight bites. I want a bite in the snare. I want a bite in the vocal, so I know it's present and comes out and demands my attention rather than just being slightly packed away from me.
We all agreed that this is some crazy tight speakers and amazing resolution is heard at all volumes. Next, the neutrality and fidelity of the bass. There is no lumps, bumps, excessiveness, just super smooth linear bass response that is great for monitoring purposes, but might feel a bit too conservative for home use. The remedy is to use the available GLM sound profiler filters to add a boost below 100 Hz, for example. We also ended up adding a bit more below 85 Hz for that physical bass. There's also some personal preference to this. Martin and Lars both prefer a good load of bass on their systems, and even I, that have been Mr.
Neutral sound is the only way
for decades, even in my home cinema, is slowly getting addicted to that. That introduces that.
Hell yeah.
Only available on systems that have the capability and headroom to create that kind of pressure. The listening session typically was divided into a first and second impression, where the participant just listens through whatever material they are using for judgment and then rambles away with the first impressions. Here, everybody expressed an initial excitement about the crisp, clear, awe-inspiring control and power of the system. We started out with a typical hi-fi tilt roll-off in the top end, expecting such monitors to be a bit bright, but quickly realized that it was not the case in this room, where it just stole some of the bite and articulation we were missing. We also ended up moving a bit further back and moved the speakers further away from the back and sidewalls as we gained a bigger sense of imaging, even though the speakers work perfectly in 1 meter distance or even closer if you need to tonality-wise. For the subsequent sessions, this was our default setup. After the initial first big impression, comments started to be made about the sound image. Tim and Martin commented on feeling it was only existing in between the speakers and not really outside. I totally agree on that. The impression of depth and height is very much there, though. Martin noted it reminded him of a listening experience he once had with a pair of JBL K2s. Carsten's experience contradicted our impression, as he said he was impressed with the soundstage outside the speakers. Carsten also made an interesting comment when going through some of his go-to reference tracks, including Bob Dylan's Man in the Long Black Coat, where he almost found the vocal to sound too polite on this system. There's some excitement missing in contrast to the way the track translates on other systems, including the Genelec home speaker previously tested here on the channel. In contrast, other tracks like AC/DC's Boogeyman received much praise, as well as Tin Pan Alley, where Carsten experienced the...
The sky is the limit, eh?
Big electronic tracks sound madly impressive too, with so much limitless power and punch available. To my surprise, old good recordings like Nina Simone's My Baby Just Care For Me and everything from the Frank Sinatra swinging sessions that I personally love sounded so alive with amazing roominess and presence. Totally unexpected for me personally. My fears of older recordings being presented in an ugly light was put to shame there. While it can be almost intimidating sitting in front of these monsters, they really do the job of a near-field monitor perfectly, just as well as a room-filling communicator, easily reaching the back row of even larger rooms. This is definitely one of the most fascinating party pieces of this speaker system, no doubt. For people working with clients in studios, it will be a very big advantage that everybody can hear precision sound where they are at. For the music lover with big arm movements, they will serve just as well, say in recreational areas of mansions, where a clean sound for everybody sitting in that huge party sofa or at the indoor pool bar is wanted. One area of the 8381A sound that I got back to again and again during my many hours of listening was that I felt some lack of microdynamics expression that I enjoy with other speakers and amps. I think it's one of those things that really connects me personally as a listener to the realism of sound, assuming everything else is in order as well, of course. I don't know if that is also related to the other listening team members expressing a lack of connection and the sound not reaching the foot tap muscles. It's a layer of texture, I think, gives the sense of missing involvement, intimacy, and in my case, intimate realism that connects to the soul. Yes, it sounds crazy, as this is a speaker system that will give you all the macro dynamics you can ask for. The cannons firing in the 1812 overture is delivered physically while the speakers go.
Do you know how easy this is for me? Do you have any fucking idea how easy this is? This is a fucking joke.
But I can't help feeling that the system lacks some transient speed, resulting in loss of finer details and microdynamics after getting used to the amazing performance overall. Actually, just like the character in Good Will Hunting, that while being an amazing genius on the measurable matrix, is an infant when it comes to the true emotional connections.
It's not your fault. I know.
Martin expressed it like, you really can't point a finger at it. For cinema, this would be amazing. Everything is there. But for hi-fi, I feel there's something missing that is hard to define, as everything really is there, so crisp, so clear, so much salad, but it's like it's not mixed on the plate yet. Sound engineer Tim Harris also expressed similar feels.
I don't know if they would be a little bit too nice over time. I don't hear the very highs of the trebles, that silkiness that some high-resolution speakers, but here's a little bit, maybe a little bit. I wouldn't ever call these tame, but maybe a little bit too well-behaved. And it's definitely no doubt that you wouldn't experience any listening fatigue with this setup, especially if you roll off the top.
If
you play too loud, then the blood starts to run out of your ears. Then there's a sign and you need to have your meter with you.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, my God.
It's amazing they can get such big speakers to function so well as close as near field. And still 4 meters away, still functions mid fields.
All this might be in the amplifiers for all we know. With an active system like this, it's just not possible to experiment with the amps as they are married to the system for life. The Genelec 8381A's primary objective is professional high-end monitoring applications. Second, it's SPL hungry audiophiles. And boy, does it deliver. It is really an exceptional main monitor with all the properties of a precision studio monitor, even though specs suggest that this must be some kind of crazy PA speaker system. It's not. It should be compared to the Genelec The Ones monitor system series, but scaled up massively to cover even bigger rooms and never run out of headroom. So is this a hi-fi speaker? While the main ones consistently will reproduce any frequency at any level for a wide audience day in and out, and carve out the sound in well-defined layers, Carsten is probably the one that nailed what we all expressed in different ways in the funniest way. Carsten expressed his listening experience as having the most mind-blowing, amazing sex ever, but without the love. Said in another way, it misses the kind of love that instantly forgives that beer belly, bad teeth, baldness, poor sexual stamina, and makes you smile at your wrinkled old partner every morning, even after 30 years. The main ones is more like a work partner, say a really capable, practical, oriented, rock-solid colleague that you can trust to always get the job done. Under the right circumstances, this could be a person generating a lot of value for what he or she does, and so does the 8381A at the price point. In short, if you're looking for a trusty tool that offers amazing precision consistency in large rooms and never run out of power, this is one totally unique proposition. On the other hand, if you are audiophile and looking for that romantic love connection to music listening through a speaker system you relax with, you will get more of this than this. No matter what, the Genelec 8381 is amazing audiophile sex, as Carsten expressed it, and it rides on the edges of speaker innovation, which we can all deeply respect. Tap, tap, tap those like and subscribe buttons, and remember, you will know all you need to know if you just listen. See you next time, and in the meantime, check out all the other awesome stuff on the channel.
You got that, maggots?
Oh, yes, sir!
Good.